So after a really, really long 3 days of hiking, staying in tents, and just really doing a lot of stuff, we're actually spending the night tonight in a hostel, which is basically like a hotel. It's just a small room, and mine's pretty nice. It's pretty cool. Here it is. Got my little bed. Of course, first thing you gotta do is you gotta start charging the gear when you get in here. So yeah, but it's pretty cool. Little mirror right here, and let's check this out. Look at that. Pretty, pretty cool. You can see the reflection of the mountains right here. Let's look at those. I'm in a little town somewhere in Peru. I'm not exactly sure where I am. I'm a little disoriented after a long couple of days, but right now we're just chilling. Probably gonna grab a quick nap, and then it will be time for us to hit the hot springs. Peruvian hot springs, fed by a little waterfall right there. It is absolutely incredible. Super, super just scenic and beautiful all around. I can't get enough of this place. This water is super warm and comfortable. Oh, it's wonderful. It's amazing. If you're ever in Peru near some hot springs, I recommend that you go try it, because it's awesome.
Good morning for day 4 here. It's a beautiful morning here. I love how the sunlight starts to touch the tops of the mountains here. Let's see if you can get a shot of that. Anyway, after a quick breakfast, we have a big day today. We are going ziplining.
I'm all strapped in, ready to go. And my helmet conveniently already came with a GoPro mount on it, so you'll be seeing some point of view shots of this experience soon. But this is the most heavy duty harness I've ever put on. But here we go, this is gonna be insane. It's a beautiful day here in the mountains, let's check it out.
So right now we are on the far side of Machu Picchu. And that is it right there. So when a train goes by, put some pennies on the track and they get absolutely squashed and the imprint is still on the track. Wow, that was awesome. Here you go.
You can keep that one.
I'll probably lose it. So we have made a new traveling companion and he is yet to be named. Here he is. Aww. So Stuart is no more, but now we have Roger. Oh. Say hi, Roger. Hello.
So we are finally almost ready for our last night here in Peru. Looks like we're going now.
It's amazing. Very excited.
Unbelievable.
What are you thinking?
It's so cool.
We finally made it to the supposed climax of the adventure.
Well, look at the mountains behind me. Kind of clearing up, but here we are in Machu Picchu. So, finally at the highest point over Machu Picchu, the sun is rising and we are getting
time lapse.
This is the highest point in Machu Picchu, the guardhouse. So here we're in the guardhouse. And if you look out, this place has got it all. We got mountains on cloud.
We got glaciers.
It's got it all.
So we found our own little isolated room here.
So we say goodbye to Machu Picchu.
So dinner tonight is
delicious stuff. Skewers. Look at this. Oh. Oh. I'm just at the skewer stand getting some skewers. So we're here in a little bit of a market surrounded by fruits and vegetables of different sorts. This little town here that we have, like, at the base of Machu Picchu is popping. Oh gosh, excuse me.
Oh, what are you doing?
In some ways it is extremely different here. And in other ways, it's not. These kids right here are just huddled around a phone playing Subway Surfers. So, that's pretty funny.
So right now, we are in the process of boarding the train. I'm like walking like almost right in the tracks. Boarding the train to go back to Cusco, Peru. And from there, we are going to fly back to Lima. And from Lima to Houston. And from Houston to Indiana.
Exiting the train to get onto a bus, 2 more hours, back to Cusco. After a train, then a bus, then a taxi, we're finally back in the same room we started with our bags waiting for us. And I am absolutely exhausted. And it's morning here in Cusco. Now we gotta catch a flight to Lima.
Thunder woke me up, it was storming in the city. I was-